you really want to focus on segmenting out one particular attribute that is the target of your proof of concept, whether that's performance or extensibility, scalability. You need to not try to take on the entire set in a proof of concept. You can't slow down design. As one example, if performance, if you take a look at an aspect of performance, you could also focus on extensibility, but when you try to combine the two or all of the above, then you get things, and those that don't know the four loco methods, just use Wikipedia.
It makes you crazy, man.
Essentially, it's a bad thing inside the design process to try to look at all those attributes of proper software architecture. You're going to slow the design down. So, that was my quick run through. Let's go on to the final takeaways here. Really what we focus on in our practice is providing value of technology through design, targeting two different groups. Designers and stakeholders, we're really wanting to make sure that we can provide better and faster expression and validation, as Jared and Greg both pointed out, so that you can really riff to innovate further. Obviously, we understand there's time to market pressures and that clients and stakeholders want you to build the real thing faster. You have to find a way, and these tools and techniques that we use hopefully give you some idea about how you can sort of segment off your design process from technology encroachment or engineering encroachment. And the other thing is for developers and engineers, if you are in a company or organization where you don't have a dedicated team like we have with design technology, that you can find a way to invite yourself into the process of interaction design where your ideas, what you know as a subject matter expert on the technology platform, can be brought in to validate that design process.